God bless you. I'm Pastor Rudy Mosley, Senior Pastor, Bread of Life International Worship Center. Extremely excited about this altar training for altar workers and also for pastors and shepherds in the house. The expectation is that when a person gets saved, is that we have a responsibility to care for that individual, care for that new life, care for that new person, and shepherd them through the process to maturity, to spiritual maturity. Here at Bread of Life, we define our discipleship program in terms of our milestone process, milestone 1, milestone 2, milestone 3, milestone 4. And so as an altar minister, we're going to go through this training right now, and I pray that it's beneficial to your life, to give you an understanding, and also to give you a clear picture of the vision of how we're going to be doing ministry going forward. The qualifications of a pastor and a shepherd and an altar worker is very simple. 1, that your family, your faith, and your finances are all strong and in order. That you're a committed, faithful member and attendee of Bread of Life International Worship Center. That you have already completed your milestone 1. And that you are a faithful tither to Bread of Life International Worship Center. Glory to God. And that you live by 1 Timothy chapter 3. Now, the expectations of a pastor and an altar worker are these. 1, being committed to a spirit of excellence. Committed to living your best life. Living your best in whatever you do. That is just the standard that we live by. God deserves our best. He gave us our best, so we want to give Him back our best. In everything that we do, we're open to constructive criticism and improvement. You know, God has called us to improve. He's called us to grow. And so He's placed different people over our lives to help us as iron sharpens iron so that we can grow in grace and in the knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. 2, there's an expectation of commitment. Faithfully attending the worship services of Bread of Life International Worship Center. Submission to the Lord's timing and the leadership's time frame for your ministry here at Bread of Life International Worship Center. And faithfully attending and being punctual for meetings. So in terms of the execution of your commitment, that is what it would look like. 3, submission. A spirit of submission where you pray for your leadership. 2, you respect and honor the leadership and submit to the guidelines and the directions that have been set forth. Submission is a spiritual mark of maturity where you submit to the governing authorities over your life. If you want the blessing of the house, you submit to the order of the house. It's no different than in a regular family where if kids want to receive the blessings and the favor of the parents, they have to submit to the authority and the direction of that house. And if they do that, then they receive the blessing and the favor of the house. You receive the spiritual blessing of that house. In terms of growth, spiritual, relational, and skill growth, being committed to growing, a pledge to be spiritually prepared to minister, which includes having a personal prayer and worship time seeking the Lord. So in terms of being prepared for the altar ministry, being prepared to minister to the people of God, that all week long, you've had your own personal devotion time. You had your own seek time. You had your own chase time. You had your own personal time. See, the Holy Spirit gives every single individual what His expectations are for their particular walk with the Lord. He gives the expectation of how much you should read, how much you should pray. And we're believing that you are being faithful to that as God is blessing your life. 5 is that you are a team player. Being a team player and growing and flowing together in cooperative unity and having a cooperative attitude. That is an expectation here at Bread of Life as an altar minister, as a member of the altar team, a member of that pastoral cohort that is shepherding people through their process in their walk with God. Communication, honorable communication between yourself, leadership, and fellow team members is an expectation here at Bread of Life. Hallelujah. And that you would develop healthy relational team dynamics through encouragement and positive exhortation. This is so exciting to be a part of a group of people who feel called to help people in their spiritual growth and development. What an honor, what a privilege, what an opportunity to serve others. Now, in terms of the purpose of the altar ministry, we pray for the needs at the altar. We pray for the needs of people. We point the way. We give new believers the material to help them grow in the initial stages of their faith. We call and encourage them to get plugged in. We constantly stress the importance of small groups. We faithfully proclaim the Word of God and encourage people to read it for themselves. In short, we point people to the way that it looks like to have a relationship with Jesus Christ for themselves. We create a clear path for them. This is where our greatest responsibility comes in to play. If we've pointed the way clearly and people are responding, it's our job to make sure that the path is clear. And then they can decide if they want to walk in it. Glory to God. So our goals, the goals that we have, because we have many different things that we do here at Bread of Life in terms of our weekend services, our online services, our services where we serve in the community, our life groups, where we have concerts, we have worship nights, we have ministries on college campuses, on high school campuses, we have youth ministry as well, we have Kingdom Kids ministry, we have many different ministries here at Bread of Life. Now, what we're believing, God, is that when people have the invitation of salvation and they give their hearts to the Lord, we're believing that at least 50% of those people who actually come to the altar will actually enroll in our Fresh Start program, that online class, so that they can learn about their next steps. Then we're believing that 25% of these new believers would actually get baptized. We're just using these as metrics so that we're able to measure our effectiveness as a ministry. This is the flow, the order of the flow, the expectation of the steps, then procedures that we're going to take so that we're all operating on one accord in agreement as we flow together. So step one, new believer attends any one of our weekend services, any one of our weekend meetings, and Pastor Rudy or another pastor gives the altar call. The new believer raises their hand at the pastor's invitation. Pastor Rudy or another pastor prays a short prayer. The prayer partners come to the front at this time with the new believer. Pastor Rudy or another pastor invites everyone to stand and encourages the new believer to come forward for prayer as everyone is standing. Step two, the new believer comes forward and meets one of the prayer partners, one of the altar workers or one of the pastors at the front. The prayer partner asks the new believer what is their name and if they are here to receive Christ. The prayer partner prays with the new believer and affirms the new believer in their decision to accept Christ as their personal Lord and Savior. The prayer partner tells the new believer that he will be praying for them and wants to call them to see how they're doing. This is where the prayer partner will take out their phone and go to the website and just click on the spot that says new believer. And complete that on the website with that person, putting in their name, their contact information. And then they'll also write down their phone number and ask them the question, what is the easiest way to get in touch with them this week? And step three, the prayer partner tells the new believer about Bread of Life's Fresh Start program and sends them the link for that program on their cell phone, or they can find it right on the website. And so that person now can begin to hear about and get grounded in the faith. The pastor gives that new believer a Pastoral Connect card, and that Pastoral Connect card simply states for that new believer that shares that person's contact information, and they let them know, if you got any questions, you got any concerns, here is my phone number, give me a call. And the prayer partner asks the new believer, what is the best way to get in contact with them? Hallelujah. And encourages them that they're going to give them a call this week. They then give them one of our gifts, and the gift is the invitation to the pastor's breakfast so they can come for free breakfast and learn more about the ministry. Glory to God. Step four, the prayer partner calls the new believer later in the week and encourages them and invites them to attend the pastor's meal. Glory to God. You can call using star 67, or you can call regular star 67, will make your number come up as private, or you can just call the person and just let them know, hey, I'm so-and-so from the church. Remember, we met at the altar. Glory to God. And I'm here just to encourage you. Did you have a chance to look at the Fresh Start video? Did you have a chance to register for the pastor's breakfast? We're looking forward to seeing you this week. Glory to God. And then step six is where that person makes a decision to attend the Fresh Start class or to watch the class online. And then step seven, one of the pastors from the house actually gives that person another call later on that week, encouraging them to see them sometime that weekend. Glory to God. Now, as a shepherd, as an altar worker, you're now going to make a commitment to shepherd this person through our discipleship process. And that is that they make their first milestone. Glory to God. And to make your first milestone here at Bread of Life is very simple. It's saved. You're baptized. You've attended new members class. You've joined the life group. And you've also watched our videos. All of the videos that are in Milestone 1 is right on our website. And you could shepherd that person through that process. And then at the end of the 8-week cycle, that person's going to get a certificate that says that they made their Milestone 1. Glory to God. Milestone 2. You'll shepherd them through it. And this is where they've attended foundations and they've also taken their spiritual gifts inventory. And so now it is identified a place for them to serve and they start serving in the house. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And they're taking foundations and they're serving and they're still attending their life group. They have made their milestone 2 at Bread of Life. Glory to God, which is part of the discipleship program. Milestone 3 is leadership. That's where they learn more about their spiritual gifts. They develop a project and they also take their life group training class. And then milestone 4 is where they are an apprentice leader for a life group or they've launched their own life group on their own. Glory to God. And the cycle just continues. Praise the Lord. Remember, Bread of Life is not a church with life groups. Bread of Life is a church of life groups. Glory to God. Because to be a disciple means that you are following the teachings of Christ, but you're also teaching others to do it as well. Amen. Praise the Lord. Here are some general expectations or general responsibilities for anyone that ministers in the house of Bread of Life. Number one, always show our guest where something is. Escort them, never point. So, you know, as somebody comes into the church and, you know, it's the beginning of service or something else is going on and they're not quite sure where to go, don't just say, just point, just why not just escort them to it? Always initiate prayer with anyone standing in a line, especially if they're waiting for Pastor Rudy to pray with them. Serve when scheduled. So if you realize that you will not be able to attend a service or an event for which you have already been scheduled, it's your responsibility to let your team leader know so that we don't have any gaps. Take pride in your appearance so that you present a positive and welcoming first impression. Please don't wear shorts or t-shirts while working a service. Do not come to the front without your shoes on. Report disturbances to the security team or a staff member. In a time of emergency, the prayer team members should follow the directions of the security staff. Be familiar with other services and ministries at Bread of Life International Worship Center. Be able to briefly share the vision of our church. Attempt to make a new believer feel great for their obedience to God. Let the new believer know if a question arises that you cannot answer, it'll be referred to a team leader who can answer their question. Someone will call them back if they desire. Encourage the new believer to attend our Fresh Start program. Invite the new believer and the family to Guest Central to meet other leaders at the end of service. And be familiar with the sinner's prayer so that you can lead new believers in that prayer. This concludes our training. Thank you so much for being a part of this incredible and important team here at Bread of Life. And we're thankful for what God is going to continue to do in and through you. Be blessed.